गुड आफ्टरनून मॉली, हाउ आर यू? ओके,
I'm fine, ma'am.
सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द लेसन फादर्स हेल्प बाय आर के नारायण. ओके, नाउ इन दिस इज अ स्टोरी अबाउट अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड नेम स्वामीनाथन एंड एवरीबडी एड्रेसेस हिम एज स्वामी एंड द एंटायर स्टोरी रिवॉल्व्स अराउंड हिम एंड ही इज द सेंट्रल कैरेक्टर ऑफ द स्टोरी. And we come to know that one fine Monday morning, he is not interested in going to school. Okay, he hates. Generally, most of the students hate to go to school on Monday mornings because after the weekend, they just don't want to get up, get ready and go to school. So that was the case with Swami. And he just made a pretext of not going to school. And he told his mother that he is having a headache and he won't be going to school. So his mother, being a lenient and kind lady, she agreed. She asked that, okay, you can stay back home. But then when he tells this to his father was a very strict man and he did not agree with him. He told that get up right now and get ready and just go to school. Okay, so but Swami doesn't realize that what consequence can happen. So he just falsely accuses his teacher Samuel, saying that, father, if I go to school late, I will be very badly beaten by my teacher. Okay. And then he gives a detailed account of his teacher Samuel's violent behavior with the boys who are late to school. And then he also tells that the teacher is so strict that he canes the hand of the children until he sees the blood. And then with that same blood, he puts the vermilion on the forehead of the children. So hearing all this, Swami's father is shocked and agitated. And he immediately pens down a letter to the headmaster, to the principal. And he says, he tells Swami that he should go to school and he should hand this letter to the headmaster. Now, Swami is very reluctant, okay, because he knew that he whatever he told about Samuel is not correct. So even though he goes to school and while going, his conscience bothers him, his conscience pinches him, and he feels that he did not do the correct thing because he recalls that Samuel teacher was not that bad a teacher and that bad a person, and he was quite okay with the students. So that's the reason he justifies. He doesn't give the letter immediately to the headmaster. He just keeps the letter in his pocket and he waits that he will misbehave in his Samuel teacher's class. And in the meantime, he will misbehave and the teacher might scold him or get violent with him, and that will justify the letter. And then he will give the letter to the headmaster. So what happens? He misbehaves in his class and at last he gets a cane from his teacher. And then he goes to the headmaster's office and he wants to deliver the letter. But he comes to know that the headmaster is on a leave, on a week's leave. And then he returns back with the letter. Now what happens when he returns back? His father was expecting. His father was already expecting that Swami was not going to give the letter to the principal because Swami was a naughty boy and a mischievous boy, according to his father. So what happens, he tells his father whatever happened, and he tells that I couldn't give the letter because the headmaster was on leave. But his father doesn't believe him. He says that he took the letter from his hand, tears it, throws it in the dustbin, and says that a boy like Swami deserves a teacher like Samuel. And that's how the story ends. And here I would like to also mention, Molly, that this story also depicts a relationship between a child and his parents. Now see, while reading, you will find that Swami is very comfortable with his mother because his mother is not that much strict. Okay, he just tells her that he's not feeling well, he's having a headache, and he doesn't want to go to school. So his mother doesn't speculate so much. She says that, okay, if you don't have any important lessons, you can skip your school today. And then he thinks that everything will be normal. But the same thing, when he tells to his father gets angry. And his father is not ready to listen to him. See, this also, this story also depicts the child psychology. Why did he want to do like this? Why did he make an excuse? Why did he not want to go to school? Or why did he give a false account of Samuel teacher's violent behavior? All this puts a question mark on a parent-child relationship and also depicts the child's psychology. But then it is a good light-hearted story. We enjoy it. Okay, and that's how the story, the characters here, the you will find that Swami is, okay, he indeed is naughty and mischievous, but he is a lovable boy also. Because when we read the text, we readers or the students find that he feels bad when he goes to the school taking that letter in his hand. He indeed feels bad that he should have not told false things about his teacher. Okay, so have you understood the summary of the lesson, Molly?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any questions?
No, ma'am.
Did you like the story?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I'll be ending the class then?
Yes.
Okay, just a second.